Juani came in and he was a ball of energy and he had a huge smile on his face and he told me that he loved wrestling. And I said, we gotta have this young man on the radio. I brought you over to see Bart Scott because Bart is a huge wrestling fan as well. And Juani, you said that you love The Undertaker. And so Bart put you in the Undertaker move. What was the name of that move?
It was Hell's Gate Undertaker Submission.
It was Hell's Gate Undertaker Submission. He picked you up. He had you hanging upside down. You were squealing, screaming, laughing. Was it scary being held upside down by Bart?
Initially.
But you were laughing after that.
Yeah.
It was pretty fun?
Yeah, it was fun. I like all the wrestlers. I don't have a favorite.
No? But you do like the Undertaker submission move, you were telling me.
Yeah. The first time I watched him use it was when he used it on Kane in their Hell in a Cell match.
Okay. All right. Now, Pete the Body Bellotti is our resident wrestling aficionado. Yes. Do you know what Juani's talking about?
Oh, absolutely. That's one of his newer finishing maneuvers, but his previous one was the Tombstone as well.
Tombstone? Juani, do you know the Tombstone?
Yeah.
Okay, how does the Tombstone go?
I can't see it because I'm visually impaired, but I know that it's his finisher.
Yeah.
His well-known finisher.
Yeah.
Pile driver.
It was pile driver. Yeah. Okay.
Tombstone pile driver.
Okay, gotcha. So Bart had you hanging upside down the other day.
Yeah.
I mean, that must have been pretty. Was it more fun or was it more scary?
It was more fun.
More fun? We'll see. If Bart's around today, I might have him do it again to you, okay? So Gracie, you've developed these labels and you've been profiled by the Today Show.
Yes.
And you've done a lot of great opportunities with media to talk about this. And what you're hoping is for young people like Juani, like your son, or anybody that's visually impaired to have these Braille labels on clothing to help get dressed in the morning.
Yes, indeed.
And how'd you come up with the idea?
Well, I came up with the idea because my husband and I saw Juani struggling. He was trying to put his clothes on one day. He was sitting on the floor and he put on his pants pretty well. But when we saw, I was like, okay, how is he going to figure out anything? How's he going to figure out to put on his clothes? You know, most products and shirts now are tagless, you know, which is like the worst thing for them. You know, they have to really feel their way to get the shirt on right.
Yeah.
So I went on Google to search. And I didn't find anything that was like, you know, that would help him, at least something with directional cues.
Yeah.
And then I had an epiphany. I truly had an epiphany. And I saw patches and I said, you know what? I think this is what I was born to do, you know? And I guess I didn't have Juani just to have Juani. I had Juani with a purpose.
Yeah.
Which is the coolest thing. Once I started to do the prototype, I just ran with it. I was like, okay, I'm going to make these patches. And then I got up one day and I looked at my shoes. I was like, I got to do something for the shoes too.
Last week when you were in here with us, you sang me a song.
Right? Okay,
you gave me a verse. Michael Jackson, 1972, Ben. Do you think you can cook that up for me again?
Yeah.
All right. Hit it.
Ben, the two of us need look no more. We both found what we were looking for. With the friend to call my own, I'll never be alone. And you, my friend, will see you've got a friend in.
Wow, that is amazing, my man. That is amazing. What can't you do? You're a talented dude. That is so good.
Thanks.
You're a great singer. Wow, how long has Juani been singing?
Since the second grade.
Since the second grade, so 5 years, huh?
The second grade was when I started performing.
Yeah, wow. And what have you performed in?
Like churches and at my own school.
Yeah.
And different schools.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you usually perform with other people or just solo?
Solo. Want to perform with other people.
He does, but he does solos most of the time. His music teacher's like, no, we're going to do a solo. We're going to do a solo.
Juani's a solo artist.
Yes, he's a solo artist.
How amazing.
Yeah.
How amazing. Wow.
And he gives kids like kids who all children, when they see him, they just feel inspired. you know, adults as well.
Yeah.
You know, bring adults to tears, you know, yeah. and things like that. But the kids kind of feel like, wow, like if he can do it,
mm-hmm.
you know, because also with visually impaired children, there's a little bit of a, you know, parents feel like there's this shame or this type of, you know, it's a sad situation. Yeah. And I'm trying to really just change the perception.
Empower those that
empower them.
And visually impaired and blind.
Yes. It, you know, it's all about empowerment. That's what all that Braille code is empowerment.
Yeah.
Is to really show the perseverance and the independence.
Yeah.
And things like that. It's very important. It's
yeah.
very important.